On the next day, the large crowd who had come to the feast, when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, took the branches of the palm trees and went out to meet him, and began to shout, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, even the King of Israel."
Hey, what's up, man? Oh, nothing. Just at work right now. Hey, you know, you've been saying that now for weeks, okay? Listen, Joe Dumars knows what he's doing, okay? He's the president of the Pistons, all right? They won a championship with him, okay? Listen, he trades for Allen Iverson because he's a superstar, okay? The guy puts up like 30 points a night, all right? You can't just pass on that. I don't care about the draft picks. I don't care about the salary. They got Allen Iverson. I mean, that's sweet. How are you going to pass on that? What's that? No, man, it's cool. I told you, I'm just at work. I'm not doing anything. I don't ever do anything anyways. That's cool, man. Seriously, it's cool. What? Yeah, later? Yeah, that's fine. I can go see that movie. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, sure. Yeah, what time? Okay. Yeah, I think that should work. I was going to swing by the...
Hey, George.
Oh, hey, Mr. Fitz.
Hey, did you get that project I asked you about?
Yes, I did actually, and the results were, I was actually just working on it, right now, and, the results were, they're just gonna, wow is all I have to say. Yes, I did finish that project, yes.
All right, that's great, good job.
Yeah, thanks, Mr. Fitz. Sorry, dude, momentary catastrophe there. Yeah, no, my boss just came and asked me about some project. Yeah, nah, I haven't even touched it yet. I told him I did, but I, yeah. What? Hey, dude, come on. It's just a little white lie. Hey. Little white lies have never hurt anybody, okay? Yeah, all right. Hey, all right, man, back off. All right, yeah, it's fine, I'll see you later. Bye.
Seeing the people, he felt compassion for them, because they were distressed and dispirited like sheep without a shepherd, and he healed many who were ill with various diseases.
Gained 20 pounds. And technically, that bag of M&Ms only had 3 pounds in it. But Jenna, it's so good. Hey, you know what else we should have?
What?
Double stuffed Oreos.
We do.
Look, in the kitchen.
Ooh, I'm not going to get those right now. I'll plan it later. Meg?
Yeah?
I can't believe that Anna did that to you.
I know, right?
She's such a gossip.
I can't trust her for anything. I told her specifically to keep it a secret.
I know.
And she told everyone.
Everyone. And I mean, she was mean-spirited about it too. It wasn't like it was just, well, here's the situation, let's try to fix it. No, it was like stab you in the back.
Oh yeah, like in the heart and twist.
Mm-hmm. And it's not just you. She does that to other people.
I know.
Like Gary and Shannon from last year, it was the same kind of thing.
What about Gary and Shannon?
You know about Gary and Shannon, right?
No.
Probably shouldn't tell you technically.
Come on, Jenna. You know it's not going to leave this couch.
Well, everybody knows that anyway.
Yeah, so you know last summer when Gary went down south with the team for training?
Mm-hmm.
Well, when he came back, he was having this accountability session with Kevin, and he was telling him about this one night, how stuff just sort of got out of hand with the team, and there was lots of drinking, and then there was this really cute blonde cheerleader chick.
Are you serious?
Oh, yeah.
I can't believe Gary would do that.
But you know what? I mean, he's kind of the cheater type, really.
It's kind of like Kevin, I guess.
How do you love Kevin?
You didn't hear?
Hear what?
Why he lost his job?
Well, they had layoffs down there.
I heard that he was taking some money from the register.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where'd you hear that from?
From Anna. She's such a gossip.
You know, gossip made me sick.
They need to learn to keep their mouths shut, all of them. Why are we the only people who understand how much gossip hurts?
I don't know. Let's go get those Oreos. Let's.
Now when evening came, Jesus was reclining at the table with the 12 disciples.
And the problem, it seems, is with you and me, not the love who came to repair everything.
As they were eating, he said, "Truly I say to you that one of you will betray me." Being deeply grieved, they each one began to say to him, "Surely not I, Lord." And he answered, "He who dips his hand with me in the bowl is the one who will betray me."
When all the love in the world is right here.
And Judas, who was betraying him, said, "Surely it is not I, Rabbi." Jesus said to him, "You have said it yourself." While they were eating, he said to them, "I have earnestly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I say to you, I shall never again eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God." Jesus took some bread, and after a blessing, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
Let us bring them relief.
And when he had taken a cup and given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for forgiveness of sins."
We can change something.
But I say to you, I shall not drink of this fruit of the vine from now on until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. After singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives.
Hey, what's up?
Hey.
Can't believe this weather. It's crazy.
Yeah, it just started snowing out of nowhere.
What's that?
Well, I found a wallet on the ground.
You found a wallet?
Think we should turn it in somewhere? I mean, there's not like a lost and found for the parking lot.
Well, yeah, we gotta turn it in, you know? Maybe we just open it up and look at his license.
Dude, there's like $200 in here.
Well, that's a lot of money.
Yeah. I don't know, should I keep it?
Well, I don't know. You could buy a lot of stuff for $200. I mean, the guy lost it anyway, right?
And if it were me, you know, I think I would like to give somebody a finder's fee for finding it, right?
Sure, yeah. And he probably wants the wallet back anyway. Like, he wants his driver's license back and maybe his cards. He probably doesn't care about the money.
The address right here, dude. It's right on Berkeley. Right down the street.
Well, we could just swing by and drop it off.
Yeah, we'll do. We'll just drop it in the mailbox.
Sure. Yeah. And then we could go and we'll do go. What would you want to buy with $200?
We could buy a Wii.
We could get a Wii. And you know, it's not like we're not hurting anybody. We're actually helping him out by giving his wallet back. No one's getting hurt.
Yeah. Let's go.
All right.
Then Jesus came with them to a place called Gethsemane and said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." Then he said to them, "My soul is deeply grieved to the point of death. Remain here and keep watch with me." And he went a little beyond them and fell on his face and prayed, saying, "My Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me, yet not as I will, but as you will." And he came to the disciples and found them sleeping, and said to Peter, "So you men could not keep watch with me for 1 hour? Keep watching and praying, that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." He went away again a second time and prayed, saying, "My Father, if this cannot pass away unless I drink it, your will be done." Then he came to the disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Behold, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is being betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. Behold, the one who betrays me is at hand." While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, came up accompanied by a large crowd with swords and clubs, who came from the chief priests and elders of the people. Immediately Judas went to Jesus and said, "Hail, Rabbi," and kissed him. And Jesus said to him, "Friend, do what you have come for." Then they came and laid hands on Jesus and seized him. Then all the disciples left him and fled. Early in the morning, the chief priests with the elders and scribes and the whole council immediately held a consultation. And binding Jesus, they led him away and delivered him to Pilate. Pilate questioned him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" And he answered him, "It is as you say." The chief priests began to accuse him harshly. Then Pilate questioned him again, saying, "Do you not answer? See how many charges they bring against you." But Jesus made no further answer. So Pilate was amazed. Now at the feast, he used to release for them any one prisoner whom they requested. The man named Barabbas had been imprisoned with the insurrectionists who had committed murder in the insurrection. The crowd went up and began asking him to do as he had been accustomed to do for them. Pilate answered them, saying, "Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?" For he was aware that the chief priests had handed him over because of envy. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to ask him to release Barabbas for them instead.
"Release Barabbas!"
Answering again, Pilate said to them, "Then what shall I do with him whom you call the king of the Jews?" They shouted back,
"Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him!"
But Pilate said to them, "Why? What evil has he done? But they shouted all the more. Wishing to satisfy the crowd, Pilate released Barabbas for them, and after having Jesus scourged, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers took Jesus to the praetorium. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and then twisted together a crown of thorns and set it on his head. They spit on him and struck him again and again.
So how was your day?
You know, I really don't want to talk about it. Just kind of the same old, same old. Have you seen the, never mind.
Did you just take money out of the jar?
Yes, I took some of my money out of the jar. The hard money that I worked for, that I earned. I'm going out with the guys tonight. Gonna watch basketball game. The Pistons are playing on TV. So, no big deal.
You can't go home. Oh, you just got home.
Yes, I just got home and now I'm just leaving.
We haven't had supper yet.
Yes, and there is no supper. I'll get something with the guys. It's not a big deal.
You know what? I am going to go in that kitchen. It's going to take 10 minutes. Supper will be on the table. You can go spend
time
with the children.
What you can make in 10 minutes isn't what I want to eat. So I'm going to go out. I'm going to just spend some time with the guys. It's not a big deal.
It is a big deal. I would like to go out with my friends tonight, too. I think that it would be great if you spent the evening with kids,
yes,
and I will go out.
Yes, but the kids don't want to spend an evening with me.
They would
so
love to spend
I'm going
time
to,
with you.
Look,
you have
I've had a rough day.
Yeah.
I'm just going to go out and spend some time with the guys. We're going to watch a little basketball, blow off a little steam. It's not a big deal.
It's a big deal because we are your family. This is where you need to be.
Yes, and if I stayed home tonight, you'd all just be mad at me like you are right now. So I'm just going to go. I'm going to spend some time with the guys. It's not a big deal.
It's a big deal.
It's a big deal because you're making it a big deal. It doesn't need to be a big deal. I'm not doing anything wrong, okay? I'm just gonna spend some time with the guys. I'm not going out to see another woman. I'm not doing anything other than spending some time with the guys. I'm not hurting anybody. Let it go.
So the soldiers took charge of Jesus. Carrying his own cross, he went out to the place of the skull, also called Golgotha. Here they crucified him.
Keep it moving. Keep it moving. keep him moving. Let's go! Let's go. Keep him moving!
When I survey the wondrous cross on which the
Hey, little white lies have never hurt anybody, okay?
That I should boast.
You know, gossip made me sick. They need to learn to keep their mouths shut, all of them. Why are we the only people who understand how much gossip hurts?
Of Christ, my God.
And you know, it's not like we're not hurting anybody. We're actually helping him out by getting his wallet back. No one's getting hurt.
I'm not doing anything other than spending some time with the guys. I'm not hurting anybody. Let it go.
Them to his blood. See from his head, his hands, his feet.
About the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
"My God! My God! Why have you forsaken me?"
Then Jesus breathed his last and gave up his spirit.
Thank you. gracious understanding. God's love so confounding appears to us in a cleansing flow of blood. Left throne in glory, bore the Father's wrath and fury in our stead, and for the sins of all he bled. Standing on worship.
Jesus Christ, the saving one.